Gangster Vikas Dubey, the main accused in the cold-blooded ambush and murder of 8 policemen in Uttar Pradesh's Kanpur, is on the run for over a week now, and a massive manhunt has been launched to nab him. 50 teams have been formed, borders have been sealed, and several of his associates have been nabbed or either gunned down in encounters. In fact, Times Now has also accessed CCTV footage of the dawn, first at Faridabad Hotel and then at a sweet shop in Faridabad, and then also fleeing in an auto from there. Let's go across to my colleagues who are joining us in the broadcast with the latest. We have Siddhant, Bhavtosh and Priyank. Let's first go across to Siddhant. Siddhant, you've managed to access the CCTV footage. In the first footage that came in, Vikas Dubey was seen at a hotel in Faridabad, but he managed to escape from there as well, and then was spotted outside a sweet shop, sitting into an auto and escaping from that location as well.
Now, see, I would like to clarify this for our viewers and would like to give the entire story, what I'm picking from locals and police. Now, Vikas Dubey was not living at a OYO room in Faridabad. Vikas Dubey was living at Ankur Mishra's residence, who happens to be a relative of Vikas Dubey, and he had given shelter to Vikas Dubey. So that particular house is in this locality, which is right opposite to the place I'm standing. So in one of those houses, Vikas Dubey have been staying. Now, yesterday in the afternoon, Vikas Dubey, as per the CCTV footages and the eyewitness accounts, Vikas Dubey came walking from the house of his relative to this main gate, to this main road. This is the main road, and this is the pole where he stood, and he waited for an auto to give him a lift. And all the entire sequence got captured in a CCTV camera, which is placed at this Bikaner Mishthan Bandar in Faridabad. So yesterday, after his escape from this place, Faridabad police got this entire tip off from UPSTF, and they were late. They were late in raiding the OYO hotels also, and they were late in raiding this residence as well. And this is the fact that before the police teams could arrive, he ran away. Now, Vikas Dubey and his associates also went to OYO room, because they later decided to shift him from the shelter here in Harinagar to OYO room. The time they went there, they did not have sufficient paper proof documents to book a room. And this is the reason that OYO room denied them admission. Now, yesterday there was a raid which was conducted by Faridabad police in Harinagar area, right opposite to this place, that particular side. It is a slum kind of area. The raid was conducted, in which the three accused and relatives of Vikas Dubey, Saurav, Prabhat and one more, opened fire on police teams. This is after Vikas Dubey had left yesterday, opened fire at police team, and 44 live cartridges have been recovered in that raid, along with the three pistols. Out of these three pistols, two pistols are the same pistol which Vikas Dubey and gang looted the time they opened fire on police personnel in Kanpur. So that those pistol and 44 live cartridges have also been recovered. Yesterday, massive raids were conducted, but police teams were raided. Immediately, three of them have been nabbed and are currently in custody. In the morning, Amar Dubey, again a close confidant of Vikas Dubey, got encountered. So massive manhunt is going on for Vikas Dubey.
Absolutely, a massive manhunt is on. Let's also go across to Bhavtosh. Borders have been sealed. The Uttar Pradesh police is coordinating with the Haryana and the Delhi police as well. 50 teams have been formed. His aides are either being nabbed or are being killed in encounters, but Vikas Dubey continues to be on run. Somehow he's managing to stay a step ahead. We do know that the cops are very close now as far as nabbing him is concerned.
Swati, the fact is that it's now over 120 hours, over 4 or 5 days. There is no clue about Vikas' whereabouts. We have CCTV footage, but it also shows that he has done immense planning. The fact that he knows that police is after him, he's changing his location time and again. More importantly, the 10 to 12 men who were part of that bloody encounter last Friday, they have split in groups. Now, it is more or less confirmed that Amar Dubey, his close associate, was with him in Faridabad, and that on Monday evening he left Faridabad. And as Siddhant was telling us, that he was gunned down early this morning. Vikas Dubey is alone, but what is worrying all the agencies, whether it's the UPSTF or Delhi police or even Haryana police, is the fact that they are very well armed. At the time of the encounter last Friday, they had also stolen AK-47 rifle, pistols, as well as INSAS rifle from the police personnel. And what they are fearing is that if at all they manage to pin him down at some place, there could be a retaliatory fire from him. And that's the reason why agencies are working very cautiously as far as this case is concerned. They want to arrest him, they want to question him, because it also will virtually open a Pandora's box. The fact that he has close association with senior police officers of UP police, and these facts will emerge only when he is caught alive and not caught dead in an encounter.
Right. Bhavtosh and Siddhant, stay on with us. And before I go across to Amir and Priyank, let's play out the reports. The first one from a sweet shop in Faridabad, where gangster Vikas Dubey was spotted and then he can be seen sitting in an auto and leaving the location.
Right now, I am at a sweet shop which is in sector 87 of Faridabad. Now, the shopkeeper and the staff here are confirming to me that yesterday, Vikas Dubey, while running away from police, first he was here almost 1 kilometer away at a relative's place. But before police teams could reach that place, he ran away and he stood there where that vehicle is parked. He stood there and his photo has been captured in the CCTV footage. So now this is a CCTV footage of a shop, and he's a shopkeeper. Yesterday, police force came here to take away the CCTV footage. Sir, कल पुलिस आई थी?
हाँ जी.
हाँ क्या बताया पुलिस ने?
तो पुलिस ने ये देखा सीसी कैमरे में देख के पहले जब वो उधर चले गए थे, फिर उसके बाद आने के बाद उन्होंने कैमरा चेक किया, कैमरे में उनकी फोटो आई, वहाँ से 3:05 पर वहाँ से बैठा वो गाड़ी में.
कौन सी गाड़ी आई थी विकास को?
ऑटो.
ऑटो में बैठ के?
हाँ जी, ऑटो में बैठ के वे चले गए इधर.
अच्छा, और ये कितना, और आपके आप लोग ने देखा था जब विकास यहाँ आया था?
नहीं, हमने नहीं देखा.
अच्छा, सीसीटीवी में? आपके
सीसी कैमरे में देखा हमने.
हमें तो जब पता चला था, जब पुलिस वाले आए थे, जब पता चला विकास दुबे था, वो
सुबह से घूम रही थी,
उसने दो बैग ला रखे थे और टांग के चला गए. दो ऑटो आए थे, दो ऑटो रुके नहीं, फिर तीसरे ऑटो में बैठ के चला गया.
ओके. So now the staff of this shop and the shopkeeper is confirming to me that yesterday at around 3 p.m. in the afternoon, Vikas Dubey came walking from his relative's residence and stood here waiting for an auto. Then he sat inside an auto and ran away. Vikas Dubey is still absconding. His three associates have been nabbed by the Faridabad police in a raid which was conducted yesterday. He was hiding at a hideout provided to him by his relative Ankur. He was staying here for the longest time. Then yesterday they decided to shift him to a hotel. Before he could be shifted to a hotel, he decided to run away from Faridabad also, and they did the same. Times Now is bringing you each and every detail from Faridabad. The first lead, the biggest breakthrough in the manhunt of Vikas Dubey. He was staying in a relative's place in Faridabad. He was spotted in a CCTV camera of this shop where I'm reporting from. The staff and shopkeepers are confirming to me Vikas Dubey came here, sat in an auto and ran away. Well, yesterday Faridabad police got tip off that Vikas Dubey, the absconder who is on the run after killing 8 policemen in Kanpur, is hiding at a place in Faridabad. Right now we are reporting from this house in Faridabad. This area is Harinagar Indira complex in Faridabad, where police got a tip off yesterday that Vikas Dubey is hiding here along with some of his associates, which includes Prabhat, Saurabh and Ankur. Now after that, Faridabad police, fully prepared, wearing bulletproof jackets and carrying sophisticated ammunition, raided this particular house yesterday. And the time of the raid, the entire house was geraud by the police force, and the time they knocked on the gate, the accused opened the gate and went on to the roof of the house. I'd ask my video journalist to pan and show you. Went on to the roof of the house, and there, when police tried to nab Prabhat, one of the close associates of Vikas Dubey, the three accused opened fire on police. This is what Faridabad police's FIR is telling us. The FIR says that 2 rounds were fired on police. Fortunately, police force got saved, and in self-defense, police force opened fire in air to nab the accused. After that, three of the accused were nabbed from this particular place in Faridabad, and the names are Ankur, Prabhat, and one of the associates of Vikas Dubey. Now, the details that we have managed to access from the police is that Vikas Dubey was indeed staying in Faridabad. He was staying in this house for the long time. After that, they decided to move him to a hotel, Oyo Hotel, and there the time he went to book a room, at that point in time he gave his identity card, but there was lack of proof with him and his associate. This is perhaps the reason that the room was not given to him by the hotel managers, and at the time he was refused the room at Oyo Hotels in Faridabad, he left Faridabad. But the point here is that before Faridabad police could nab him, before UPSTF could reach and raid this place and the hotel in Faridabad, again, Vikas Dubey managed to run away. There is no clue where Vikas Dubey is at this point in time. In the morning, Amar Dubey has been encountered by the UP police, close aide, right-hand man of Vikas Dubey. But you see, absconder in Uttar Pradesh who killed 8 policemen, 7 still are injured in Chobepur area of Kanpur, was hiding at this particular residence in Faridabad. This residence belongs to relative of Vikas Dubey, Ankur, and his relative had given him shelter here. He was living here safely. Now we have tried speaking to the locals also, but they are not confirming because of the police pressure. You can see the police deployment have also been placed here.
So Vikas Dubey stayed at his relative's place in Faridabad, but he was also spotted outside a hotel in Faridabad where he was denied a room. Let's take a look at this report.
One of the most wanted gangsters, Vikas Dubey, who is involved and who is the main accused in the killing of 8 policemen in Kanpur district in Uttar Pradesh, was hiding in Faridabad. According to the police sources, the moment the police reached this particular hotel, which is in Faridabad, it's Sri Sasaram Hotel, Oyo Hotel in Faridabad area, where apparently, according to the sources, Vikas Dubey and 2 of his aides were hiding here. So in this particular hotel, they had come and they wanted to check into the hotel.
Breaking input coming in at this point in time. Times Now has accessed the testimony of a cop posted at Shivrajpur police station. Listen into this. The testimony will startle you about how Don, the gangster, despite serious charges against him, managed to escape every time.
अरे तिवारी जी, ये बताइए कि जो आप बता रहे थे, इनका शौक क्या शौक था?
इनका शौक जो है केवल फैसला करना, क्षेत्र के 10-20 फैसले पर डे निपटाना था इनका, यही शौक कारण है। इसी में मुकदमे लिखे गए और इस सबसे बड़ी यही बात इनकी रही, महत्वाकांक्षा, धन लोलुपता और महत्वाकांक्षा कि लोग जाने के पंडित का दरबार लगता है, ये सबसे इसका अहम मुद्दा रहा।
और ये जो पिछले 20 साल से ज्यादा हो गए
जी,
मुकदमा 93 में लिखा गया
जी,
तब से लेकर आप तक परिवार वालों ने समझाया नहीं है? कोई ऐसा नहीं था कि
समझाने वालों ने, जिन्होंने समझाया उसको गाली के अलावा कुछ मिला नहीं सर? भैया, उसको गाली के अलावा कुछ नहीं मिला। गाली मार सगी जो जिस माँ ने पैदा किया उसको मारा तो टट्टी पेशाब तक हो गई।
जेल से भी मर्डर करवाते थे
जी?
जेल से में रहकर भी मर्डर करवाते?
हाँ, जेल से ही तो करता था, ज्यादातर जेल से करता था। जो और मुकदमे हैं जेल के हैं, बाकी जो है क्षेत्र में जितने, जैसे आपके सांसद जी थे राजा रामपाल, इनसे संबंध है हमारी जानकारी में।
और विधायक एक केपी सिंह का नाम?
हाँ, केपी सिंह से संबंध थे,
जो बीएसपी में थे।
जो बीएसपी में थे,
समाजवादी पार्टी की ये थी जो पूर्व मंत्री रही पिछली सपा सरकार में।
45/2001, 145/92, फिर 174/2002।
आजीवन कारावास है जी, केवल एक मुकदमे में।
अच्छा, मतलब एक ही मुकदमे में इनका वो हुआ,
आजीवन
कारावास हुआ, लाइफ सेंटेंस। तो इसमें क्या पेरोल पे चल रहा है?
हाईकोर्ट पे बोल रहे हैं ना, भाई
बेल हो गई हाईकोर्ट से। अच्छा, जितने मुकदमे हैं उसमें ज्यादातर में जो है एक्विटल ही हो जा रहा है या चार्जशीट नहीं?
जैसे सजा रेहा वो होती है तो इस पे कोई चार्ज नहीं बना,
कोई दोषी
दो, 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 जैसे दो सिद्ध नहीं हुआ, ये भी
ये तो क्या कारण रहा होगा इसका?
गवाही लेचर होगी,
गवाही या तो इन्होंने दिखा दिया भाई उसमें तो मैं नहीं था, सिद्ध कर दिया इनके वकील ने, इनको चार्ज नहीं मिला।
एक दो तीन चार,
चार 302 के चार हैं, ठीक है। एक आपने जो बताया वो 143/2001, एक 45/92, फिर एक 174/2002,
एक 136/2000। इसमें आजीवन कारावास है जी, केवल एक मुकदमे में।
अच्छा, मतलब एक ही मुकदमे में इनका वो हुआ आजीवन कारावास हुआ, लाइफ सेंटेंस। तो इसमें क्या पेरोल पे चल रहा है?
हाईकोर्ट में बोल रहे हैं ना भाई,
बेल हो गई हाईकोर्ट से। अच्छा, जितने मुकदमे हैं उसमें ज्यादातर में जो है एक्विटल ही हो जा रहा है या चार्जशीट नहीं?
जैसे सजा रिहा होती है तो इस पे कोई चार्ज नहीं बना,
कोई
दो सिद्ध नहीं हुआ, ये भी
ये तो क्या कारण रहा होगा इसका?
गवाही लेचर होगी,
गवाही या तो इन्होंने दिखा दिया भाई उसमें तो मैं नहीं था, सिद्ध कर दिया इनके वकील ने, इनको चार्ज नहीं मिला।